is something to what?
Okay, we have the Cipla numbers with us, and I'm just opening the release. On the face of it, the numbers are not looking that great. Okay, I have the release now with me. And if I look at the net profit, I think it's 178.6 crores. That's the number, which is a pretty weak number when you look at the overall basis. It's not that great. The net sales number is 3,495. That's absolutely flat on a YOY basis. So that's the sort of number that they have done. And if I look at, and if I just back calculate the, okay, there is an exceptional loss of around 77 crores. Even if I adjust for that, you know, it's not looking that great. So it's a miss on all the counts. So if you look at the scorecard of the company, the PAT is lower, the EBITDA is surely lower, and the sales is lower as well. So it's a miss on all the counts as far as Cipla is concerned. That's the PAT number, 179. Even if we adjust it for 77 crores, it's a very weak number. Now I have the profit, I have the PBT number with me, which is 276 crores, a depreciation of 284, along with that a finance cost of 35 crores. Even if you adjust for that, you know, it's not particularly that great. In fact, the other operating income has drastically gone up, which has taken the numbers slightly higher. Otherwise, you know, they are a very, very weak set of numbers, whether you look at EBITDA, whether you look at the PAT number, or you look at, you know, the sales numbers as well. Absolutely flat in terms of sales. Let's see what do they do in terms of their guidance. So let's just wait and watch for that. Nayanthara, you know, it's quite alarming to see such numbers. You know, you had Strides the other day, which was down 40%. You had Dr. Reddy's, even though the stock ended at the top gainer. It was a very weak set of numbers, and this definitely is a weak set of numbers. I'll just tell you, when I was making the poll, Nayanthara, the 179 crore number that you can see, the lowest number in the poll was 310. And that analyst itself told me it is difficult that, you know, they will mostly cross 310 crores. So that's how big this number is. The analyst who had 310 crores also told me that, it's not that great in terms of numbers. Okay, we have the consolidated revenues now, 3,698. They have just added the other operating income. Just because the other operating income is 200 crores, that's why, you know, you're getting these numbers. Otherwise, it's just broadly in line. I think we have some perspective coming in on this. Ranveer Singh of Systematic Securities is now joining in. Ranveer, what's your first thought? It's a big miss?
No, can't say a big miss, but slightly lower than expectation. The details number I am yet to see, but what broadly it looks like that probably in US market, like the others, the other generic players are facing the challenges. The same is hampering Cipla's performance also.
You know, what is the sense that you get now that you have Dr. Reddy's numbers out, Strides was the way it is, Lupin did not give a good outlook, and now with these Cipla numbers, what can you conclude for the U.S. business?
Yeah, so nobody even talking about a positive outlook for U.S. business, at least for next few quarters, because the generic pricing pressure continues. All factors which affected performance of players, generic players, are intact. So only way to achieve a growth there is to have a good flow of new product pipeline. And I think few players, big players at least, like Dr. Reddy's or Sun Pharma, Lupin also, are facing a problem from US FDA issues also, because certain sites are not getting approvals. So that is a factor affecting performance even for next few quarters. So that scenario is likely to continue. But as I see, even the global players.
I think that there is an issue with that network, but what we could broadly gather is that, you know, there nobody seems to be talking about a positive U.S. market. Cinderella, research analyst, pharma at Dolat Capital is now joining us. What is your first take? I think that there is also an issue with that line as well. So we'll just try and dial her once. Okay, Ranveer is still with us. Ranveer, you know, if you could just talk about, for a company like Cipla, The US business itself is not very big at this point of time, and most of the growth is likely to come in from new launches. So even if a company like Cipla is facing issue in US market, that means that things are really not great there.
Yeah, obviously. So that problem is not any particular company per se. So unless we have some, very, very niche product, competition is affecting, most of the players. And top line players are especially affected. The second sentimentally negative for Cipla is the negative OPI outlook there. And sometime back, they targeted this area also, but I think there also positive things are not coming in. So for U.S. per se, I think although if I compare it with other players like Lupin or Dr. Reddy's or Sun Pharma, at least Cipla has showcased some product pipeline that is going to unfold in next few years, so that will drive their growth. But this business is just facing competition. There's the challenges are there, so that scenario I do not see a major change in that scenario going to happen in next few quarters. The growth, although in non-US business market, is obviously they can see some positive traction there.
Can you just tell us that what is the sense that you get as far as the entire largely the guidance is concerned? What will you look out for in terms of guidance?
Yeah, so obviously we'll see how management looks and how they make a strategy to achieve a growth. But I think it's quite some time now that the generic pricing pressure or the challenges are now well known to each of top players, and they obviously working hard to devise some strategy to deal with it. And so for Cipla also, we will like to hear the management how they are going to deal with it. But unless I have all the numbers, which I do not have right now, all the numbers of geography wise breakup, so not able to comment exactly what has happened. So
to watch out for in Dr. Reddy press conference.
So yeah, in Dr. Reddy, I think the result, although it has been a little lower than our expectation, but what I see positive on two sides, that one, the gross margin they have been able to improve on Y-on-Y basis despite the challenges in generic business facing in US. So despite all these challenges, I think although on Q&Q basis there has been a decline in their gross margin, but yet this is solicing that at least on Y&Y basis they have been in good range of gross margin level. And I see in other geography, in most of the geography, although they have seen a decline in sales, but the way market anticipated so there was no big negative surprise for Dr. Reddy. Yes, it was a little lower than expectation. So for management perspective, I think we'll see the only hangover of the company is that US FDA related issue, so that we have to see when they are going to whether they have reached to any conclusive stage or not. And secondly, about some product launches, some key product they had earlier showcased is yet to be launched. So that commentary would be specifically important for US market perspective. Yeah.
Right. Cinderella is also now with us. Cinderella, what's your first take on Cipla numbers?
They look bad, yeah. I mean, despite the, exceptional, even if we ignore that, the EBITDA has come weaker than the previous quarter also. So I'll just wait for the breakup and see how the numbers are, because we were expecting Pulvicor, Depozen and all these to contribute this quarter. It looks like the contribution is not as the right expectation.
For in terms of guidance?
Sorry?
What will you watch out for in terms of guidance for FY19?
We'll see. I mean, there are, in terms of Cipla, there are 2-3 segments that we need to watch for. One is India, of course. Second is the ARV part of it. I mean, the South African business. And then the third is the US business. So whether they will be profitable or not is the first question that we need to understand. That at least this year, we were expecting that they will be more than breaking one. I mean, the US segment should become profitable for the company. But we will watch for those all points, as well as if any other niche approvals, as company had highlighted earlier, every quarter they would expect a niche or a differentiated launch to come their way. So if anything on those lines that we get to hear, we would be definitely looking forward to these kind of details.
Right. Thank you so much, Cinderella, for taking out time for us. Ranveer, always good to get perspective from you. We'll soon be cutting across to the Cipla press conference. I think in the next 5-10 minutes you should get more details about the press conference. I believe Samit Chauhan is also with us. Samit, technically Cipla, Dr. Reddy's, can you give us some perspective on the levels to watch out for?
No, clearly since last few days, most of the pharmaceutical stocks have taken a strong beating. As far as the Cipla is concerned, there has been a nosedive from the levels of 600 in last 2-3 weeks, and stock has even reached its important support level of 535. The overall structure looks quite weak. There could be a possibility of some kind of relief rally. So in case of a bounce back, 540, 550 looks to be a very strong resistance zone. As far as Dr. Reddy is concerned, yes, this stock has also broken its important support levels. But today's bounce back was quite surprising, and it has happened with substantial rise in volume. So tomorrow's first half would be quite crucial. If the stock manages to surpass 2050, we could see continuation of this move. However, at the higher level, you could see some kind of selling pressure coming.
Picks at this point of time?
Sorry?
Any top picks at this point of time after the markets today?
We would go with Balram Chini. This is the one stock that we have been closely tracking since last couple of days, and in the morning also we had recommended somewhere around 69. So we would continue with this positive stance on Balram Chini. Near term target would be around 82 now, and one can go long with a stop loss of 69 rupees. Rather, it would be an Ambuja Cement. This stock has corrected significantly in last 2-3 weeks. However, 2.5, 2.6, according to us, seems to be a near term support, and from here we expect a decent relief rally. So one can go long with a stop loss of 203 and expect a decent move toward 2.5.
Right, Samit. Just stay on with us. We're taking a break. Coming back in 2 minutes. Focus on numbers that will declare tomorrow. Also, the Cipla press conference should start any moment. Let's see what do they have to say on the numbers.